And welcome back to the most amazing channel on the internet. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we are talking about the top 10 scary effects of climate change. And I have to say that actually, it is pretty worrying. Before we get into that though, I want to start off the video with something positive before we delve into the doom and gloom. Let's talk about our video sponsor, Buns. Now by now, you guys will have heard of Buns. Buns is an amazing trading community that started in Toronto and is now taking off over the world. Buns aims to help us all live more sustainable lives by encouraging us to trade rather than buy brand new things, therefore saving us money and saving the planet. A lot of energy goes into producing new things like clothing. Did you know that 2,700 liters of water goes into producing one t-shirt, which is mind-boggling. I've actually swapped loads of things, including clothes, on my community in Buns. One person's trash is another person's treasure and all of that. You never know what someone near you may be wanting to get rid of. Now, Buns also does allow you to earn a cryptocurrency BTZ, and legit story, I used my BTZ to buy this skirt yesterday from a vintage shop in this city. Now, you guys often comment on things that I wear, and I think that buying new stuff all of the time can be pretty costly and unsustainable. I still do it, but I try and buy vintage and trade for clothes on Buns. Vintage is cool anyway. So if you guys want to trade with people in your area, then download Buns. There's a link in the description box, and use Rebecca Felgate, no spaces, as your referral. So that's at Rebecca Felgate, no spaces. You can also add me and trade with me yourself. If there's no one trading in your area yet, do not worry, there will be soon, and you could be the person that starts a community, which will feel pretty nice. So go ahead, check out the link in the description, and start trading. Okay, back to scary climate change. Coming in at number 10, we have dead bats. In November 2018, a third of Australia's spectacled flying fox bats dropped out of the sky dead. The mass death was described by some as biblical, as the amount of dead bats reached over 23,000 for just one species. Another species, the black flying foxes, dropped dead in epic proportions too, over 10,000 of those died. The mass death came as temperatures were the second highest ever recorded in Cairns. The mercury tipped 42.6 degrees Celsius, which is hot, hot, hot. While climate change skeptics will point out that the highest temperature of 43.2 degrees was recorded in 1923, the trend for higher temperatures has increased over the past 20 years. Dr. Wellbergen, a leading ecologist, said, "It is clear from the present data that these heat events are having a very serious impact on the species, and it's clear from climate change projections that it is set to escalate in the future." So, more dead bats. Coming in at number 9, we have no honey. It seems that climate change is playing havoc with bees. Between 2017 and 2018, US beekeepers reported a 40% loss in their hives. Now, that was a 33% increase from the year before. The past decade has been plagued with a mysterious event called colony collapse disorder. A lot of ecologists and climate scientists are pinning this on extreme weather patterns. Professor Jeffrey Williams said, "Changes in climates and weathers affect food and forage for bees. It's pretty obvious. If you have bees already on the edge and you have a radical quick weather shift, they aren't going to do well." Now, bees dying out would be pretty catastrophic for the food chain. We did a video on it on Life's Biggest Question, so you could go ahead and watch it. But to put things super simply for us humans who don't always care so much about that kind of thing, no bees means no honey. It's not just honey we're gonna have to live without, it might be a lot of food groups. Coming into number 8, we have famine. As temperatures rise and fresh water depletes, there will be many, many more droughts in inland areas, especially in the Midwest of the United States. Droughts mean failing crops and famine. Famine means people starve to death. Meanwhile, the rise in ocean levels and unpredictable weather patterns will likely trigger earthquakes, tsunamis, and volcanoes. Again, this will lead to further destruction of food supplies and also increase the likelihood of sickness contracted from the fallout. Coming into number 7, we have acid oceans. Doesn't sound great, does it? So climate change isn't the only consequence of fossil fuel burning and the increase in carbon pollution. As we burn more fossil fuels to generate more electricity, and as humans rely more on car travel and air travel, increased levels of carbon dioxide are in the atmosphere. We know this. But what a lot of people don't know is that actually a lot of this carbon dioxide is getting absorbed by the ocean. Ocean algae is really great at absorbing carbon dioxide and cleaning the air, but the current high levels are getting too much for the algae to deal with, which means the pH levels of the oceans are decreasing. Basically, this means that the ocean is becoming more acidic. An acid ocean isn't great for anyone, especially animals that live in it. Oceanic acidification is one of the key contributors to the mass extinctions we're currently seeing in our seas today. Now, if you weren't aware, over 70% of ocean life has gone extinct since the 1970s. Coming into number 6, we have ocean swallowing cities. It is estimated that if the ice sheet melts at the current predicted rate, the United States will lose the historic city of New Orleans by 2080, although Louisiana is acting fast to try and preserve the coast to the tune of $50 billion. New York City is also under massive threat, as is the majority of the eastern seaboard. The United States has money to be able to deal with issues like this, but poorer countries are going to suffer. It is estimated that with the coastal water pollution, the Philippines will likely lose almost all of its fresh water, which means that people will start getting very, very, very thirsty. We'd better master farming with salt water, as if not, the loss of fresh water is going to mean even more famine. More of a scary visual than a scary effect, but you know I love bringing this up. Coming in at number 5, we have blood falls. Blood falls is basically our favorite topic of conversation here at Most Amazing. It's a big visual metaphor too, like blood. Located amid the Taylor Glacier in Antarctica, the cascading blood-like waterfall is kind of a visual metaphor for global warming. Why? Well, as temperatures have risen in the South Pole, ice is melting. Of this we know. But the thing is about the Taylor Glacier is that the more ice melts, the more red water flows. And no, it isn't actually blood, that would be kind of crazy, but it is an iron substance, and blood of course is filled with iron. The falls would also even likely smell quite blood-like. So the red colouring is due to oxidized iron in brine salt water, like rust basically. When the iron-bearing salt water comes into contact with oxygen, the iron oxidizes and takes on a red colour. Blood. Basically, in effect, it dyes the water above into kind of a blood-like colour. The more the ice melts, the more water comes into contact with it, the more the blood falls flows. Coming into number 4, we have weather swings. Climate change isn't actually just about global warming, it's about, well, climate change. While global temperatures are increasing steadily, so much so that New York will feel like Jonesboro in Arkansas, 9 degrees hotter and 28% drier by the summer of 2080, climate change also means wider extremes. High heat means heavy downpours, which has been especially felt in the Northeast, Midwest, and Upper Great Plains of the USA. But yes, there have also been massive cold snaps too. How can this be? Well, colder snaps don't undermine scientific consensus, as some leading politicians may claim. While global temperatures are rising, gases in the air affect air patterns, which can lead to polar vortexes and extreme weather. The Nature Communications Journal wrote, "Warm temperatures in the Arctic cause the jet stream to take these wild swings, and when it swings farther south, that causes cold air to reach further down south too." So basically, expect the unexpected. Coming into number 3, we have stinky oceans. As climate changes, it is messing with our current atmospheric trends. At the moment, the Earth has something called the thermohaline circulation. This basically controls warm and cold air around the globe. It is driven by global density gradients created by surface heat and freshwater flux. Honestly, I got that sentence from Wikipedia, but basically what it means is that England is warm because of the jet stream. If it wasn't there, if the jet stream wasn't there and there was no warm air conveyor belt, then it would experience bitter winters like upstate New York and Canada. I can vouch for them, they're very cold. So basically, we don't really know what will happen with the jet streams, but ocean scientists predict that if it stops working the way it does now, oceans will get stagnant and start to absolutely stink. Why? Well, a stagnant ocean will encourage the breeding of a certain type of bacteria that releases hydrogen sulfides, which smells pretty awful, like rotten eggs. Oh, and also, it's super poisonous to us. Great! Coming in at number 2, we have wildfire. Last year was bad for fires, and that's no coincidence. As climate change takes grip, we are seeing more and more wildfires. Wildfires took a hold of Alaska and Indonesia in 2015, 2016 saw horrible fires in Canada, Spain, and California, 2017 saw fires ravaging in Chile, and we all know what happened last year up the west coast of the United States. I went to Banff recently and they said that the summers have become really unpredictable now because they have to factor in how much smoke they're going to be breathing in. It seems that large forest fires in the western United States have been occurring nearing 5 times more often since the 1970s and 80s. Now these fires are then burning 6 times the land area as before and lasting almost 5 times longer. Wow. Okay, so it's hard to categorize this list as it all seems pretty scary, but because we started this list with an animal, I want to end with one. This is a pretty headline-grabbing animal as well. Coming into number one, we have the creation of pizzly bears. Pizzly bears. They are the sick climate-induced love child of a grizzly bear and a polar bear, two of the most ferocious and aggressive bears currently in existence. Hooray! It seems that climate change has meant that grizzly bears are heading north in search of cooler climates, while polar bears are remaining on land longer as Arctic ice diminishes. Chris Savaheen, a grizzly bear expert at the University of Montana, did an interview with the Guardian publication in which he said, "The combination of warmer temperatures and vegetation growth means that there is more overlap between the species, and I would expect that overlap to increase." So yes, of course evolution has seen the rise and decline of species and the formations of new ones in the past, but the pizzly bear, with its sharp claws, seems pretty worrying to me. So guys, that was that. What can you do about this? What can you do to tackle the scary changes that are coming? Well, I guess try and be a little bit more aware and a little bit more sustainable. Electricity production burns fossil fuels, which adds to the problem. Industry uses a lot of electricity. But buying vintage or trading with apps like Bunz, you can make use of what we already have rather than encouraging the production of something new when we simply don't need it. So thank you once again to our video sponsor, Bunz. Do check out the link in the description box if you want to download it and get trading in your area. Don't forget to use me as your referral at Rebecca Felgate with no spaces. So I'm going to read some comments from the scary cults you don't want to meet. Now, one of you said that you would love to join the cult of Rebecca Felgate followers, and honestly I'm flattered, but I don't know what I would do with you all. I don't want to be a cult leader. I guess I'd just like get you all to chill out, be kind to people, and live happy, healthy lives. But that just sounds like being a good person rather than being a follower of me. Austin Ryan said, "That satanic church has way better bench seating than normal churches." I guess that's what happens when you're raising money for Satan and not putting it back into the community. Great, great chairs. That's what we should all be focusing on. Good. Philip Dean Thomas had a great suggestion. He said, "Can you please do top 10 silly things brought by billionaires, please?" Yes, why don't we? Yes, yes, I'd like that. I'd like that. I'm running out of words, it's too much today. So thank you guys for watching this video, and thank you once again to our video sponsor. Please do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and I'll see you soon. Bye.